evening and welcome to this edition of News Leader on 6. Today is Tuesday, May the 7th, 2019. I'm Jim Fuller.
And I'm Andrew Todd. In tonight's news, the Tennessee General Assembly has passed a law which changes how you can use your cell phone. A Manchester fireman was the impact speaker for a motorcycle safety awareness event in Nashville. And we'll talk with Dot Watson from the Coffee County Literacy Council. We'll have all these stories and more on tonight's News Leader on 6.
Keith Barnett here at Russell Barnett Ford of Winchester. Check out the 2018 Ford F-150 as low as $34,739. That's Russell Barnett Ford on 41A in Winchester, home of the lifetime powertrain warranty. And remember, my question is, why buy anywhere else?
It takes an Olympic effort to face Alzheimer's disease. Since 1983, Alzheimer's Tennessee has been a partner for those leading the fight against dementia, stepping up for their loved ones, and volunteering for the cause. When it happens to your family, you understand the need. Alzheimer's Tennessee was here for me, and they're here for you.
Sign up today for the Alzheimer's Tennessee Purple Olympics, Saturday, May 11th at Tullahoma High School. Go to alztennessee.org to help make Alzheimer's a memory.
Ah, the glory days. Running to daylight on the gridiron and chasing a ball with a mind of its own. Cheering the team to victory and marching to the beat of your own drum. Memories that last a lifetime. But sometimes we're reminded of our glory days in ways we'd rather forget. Get back in the game. The rehab team at Life Care Center of Tullahoma is ready to help you live and play well.
Welcome back. The Tennessee Senate approved a bill last week which would make it illegal to talk on your cell phone while driving unless you are using some kind of hands-free device. The legislation had previously been approved by the Tennessee House. The law prohibits drivers 18 and older from holding or physically supporting a phone while driving unless they are using an earpiece, headphone, or a device worn on a wrist to conduct voice-based communications. Drivers under the age of 18 are already prohibited from talking on the phone while driving, and all drivers are banned from texting while driving. It is also illegal in the state to use a handheld phone device while driving in a school zone. The bill excludes law enforcement, first responders, utility workers, and individuals using a phone to make an emergency call. If signed by Governor Bill Lee, the law would go into effect January 1st of 2020.
The Tennessee General Assembly unanimously approved a budget for the upcoming year last week. According to State Representative Rush Bricken, it is a fiscally responsible budget that builds upon recent strategic Republican-led investments that makes thoughtful expenditures across state government and preserves Tennessee's AAA bond rating. It invests approximately $239 million into the Rainy Day Fund, which now totals roughly $1.1 billion. Budget makes an $11.3 billion total investment in education, including $6.6 billion in K-12 funding. Approximately $71 million will fund teacher salaries, while $39.4 million will fully fund the state's basic education program to cover growth and inflation in the funding formula. Budget also invests $40 million to secure schools and $25 million to expand vocational and technical training opportunities.
Tullahoma has a new physician. John Gray spoke with Dr. Danielle Henson.
And we were just discussing the fact that you're from Alabama.
Yes.
And then you've been in Franklin for?
We've been in Franklin for the past 5 years, but I was originally born and raised in Alabama.
And at Franklin, you had a practice there?
I had a practice with Murray Regional. Actually, it was in Spring Hill.
Okay.
Which is only about an hour away from here.
Right. Yeah, we play Spring Hill in football from time to time. Sometimes it's not very much fun. But what is your discipline?
I am board certified in family medicine. I've been in practice for the past 5 years. And I see patients of all ages, so I do a little bit of everything.
Wonderful.
Yeah, and my passion is actually preventative medicine, is trying to prevent these chronic conditions through healthy lifestyles. And then also, if someone already unfortunately has a chronic condition, let's try to manage it through
right.
Diet and exercise and try to do less of pills. Right. I do. I try to take care of my patients myself, and I only refer to specialists when it really gets over my head. But I do try to treat my patients holistically as a whole, not only just physically, but mentally and emotionally and spiritually.
Are you finding telehome enjoyable so far?
I sure am. Every single person that I have met has been so warm and welcoming, and I already feel more as part of a community in this past 4 weeks that I've been here than I have in many, many years.
Well, good, good. And your husband is?
My husband
named
is Jonathan.
Jonathan?
Yes, and he does finances.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so he has found something to do in town as well?
Not yet.
Not yet.
He is looking to network right
okay.
now.
He's well, that's good.
VP of Finance in Brentwood right
okay.
now, but definitely needs to get a job down here.
Very good. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank
it's
you
just
so
a great
much.
Pleasure to meet you, and welcome to our community. And we'll look forward to many, many years of that smile and those beautiful bright eyes.
I hope
eyes.
So.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
After these messages, we'll be right back.
Keith Barnett here at Russell Barnett Ford in Winchester. Check out the 2018 Ford Taurus, yours today for $26,992. That's Russell Barnett Ford on 41A in Winchester, home of the lifetime powertrain warranty. And remember, my question is, why buy anywhere else?
When your family suffers the loss of a loved one, the caring and compassionate staff at Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel are standing by to assist you in every way possible. We are proud to support local industry and offer only Batesville caskets. Many funeral homes don't own or operate a crematory. We utilize the only crematory in Coffee County. Your loved one never leaves Coffee County. We can accommodate any need and any budget. Consider our complete pre-need service to remove this burden from your family during their time of grief. Lock in today's low costs and protect from inflation. Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel. Our family caring for your family.
Can you imagine a world without beauty, without color, without creativity, without art? Well, neither can we. Keep arts alive and experience all kinds of arts and crafts at the second annual Arts Alive Tullahoma on the newly renovated lawn of the South Jackson Civic Center, May 25th and 26th. For details, visit TullahomaArtsCouncil.com and come spend the day at our fun, family-friendly arts festival.
Welcome back. May is Motorcycle Safety Month, and the Tennessee Department of Safety held an event to raise awareness at Opera Mills in Nashville. Manchester firefighter Andrew Floyd was the guest speaker.
Good morning. I'm Vic Donahoe, the director of the Tennessee Highway Safety Office, and thank you all for being here. Today kicks off National Motorcycle Safety Awareness Month. We're here at the 9th annual Music City Police Motorcycle and Training Competition here at Opry Mills. I want to thank Opry Mills for the use of their facility and all the motorcycle riders from across the state and another nation for being here. As the weather warms up, we know that more motorcycles will be driving on our Tennessee roadways. And we're asking everyone, motorcycle riders and all the motoring public, to look twice and share the road with these motorcycles. The motorcycle number of crashes last year far exceeded the year before. And we're asking everyone just to pay attention. Look for these motorcycles. Look for police motorcycles. As the warm weather comes, you will see more police bikes out working traffic, working the roads, trying to make the roads safe. We accomplished this goal of safety in numbers, in voluntary compliance by the motoring public and by riders of motorcycles. We asked you all to obey the laws, pay attention to the speed limits, and look twice before you change lanes, whether on a motorcycle or in a motoring vehicle. We're honored today to have Andrew Floyd here as our impact speaker. He's from Manchester, Tennessee. Unbeknownst to me, his grandfather is Frankie Floyd, who's a longtime public servant, worked for the Department of Safety many years and retired. I worked with Frankie many years myself during my career here at the Department of Safety, and I appreciate you being here, and his father is here as well from Manchester. Andrew, thank you for being here and look forward to listening.
Thank you, sir.
As the director said, my name is Andrew Floyd. I'm a firefighter with Manchester Fire and Rescue. I've been there about 4.5 years now. I'm here to talk about a motorcycle crash I was involved in August of 2013. I was T-boned coming through an intersection by a driver who failed to yield at a stop sign. I received multiple injuries. I had a compound fracture of my left tibia fibula. I had a fractured hip socket, a dislocated iliosacral joint on the left side of my hip, a compound fracture of my left humerus, and severe radial nerve damage. I was airlifted to Erlanger in Chattanooga, where I received two surgeries, one 8 hours to fix my arm and my leg. The other was 13 and a half hours to put my hip back together. I spent a week there and 2 weeks in a rehab hospital to try to keep everything to heal the way it was supposed to. I think all in all, I had two rods, multiple plates, and we lost count at 47 pins and screws to put everything back together. After I was released from the hospital, I spent 3 months in a wheelchair, non-weight bearing, until I was released to light weight bearing. I spent another several weeks on crutches and then finally returned to normal weight bearing and got myself back in shape and was hired on with the Manchester Fire Department in less than a year's time from the motorcycle accident. So my story ended very well, all things considered. That doesn't happen in an accident of the violence that mine was. I actually received road rash, the doctor touched on it, under my armored jacket from the impact my arm took. Just the abrasion from the armored pad took skin off of my elbow. As far as motorcycle safety, you know, that's what we're here for today. I can't stress enough how much PPE, you know, personal protective equipment. I had a full face helmet on, and when I got back home and actually looked at my helmet, it broke the visor off, and I had a white paint streak on the chin bar from the hood of the car. Had I not had that on, that would have been my face, and I probably wouldn't be here talking to you today. I was wearing an armored jacket, so I had no road rash at all, just orthopedic injuries. And there's, you know, I did everything right. Speed was not involved. I was doing 30 miles an hour. The other driver wasn't paying attention and failed to yield, and she hit me. So, you know, let's pay attention when we're driving. You don't want to take somebody like me who had a dream. I was actually enlisted in the Marine Corps and waiting on my ship date to boot camp when this happened. And the wreck rendered me unable to serve in the military. That was a dream I had ever since I was little, and that was taken away from me at no fault of my own by somebody who wasn't paying attention, who was careless. So when we're driving, let's not do that. You know, let's pay attention and watch for motorcycles. Give them the respect they deserve, just like any other driver. And as the riders, all the officers here that ride motors, you know, watch your six, keep your head on a swivel. You never know what the other driver's gonna do. And you don't wanna end up waking up in a hospital ER room with no idea what happened, like I did.
We'll be right back with more News Leader on 6.
It's not invoice. It's not MSRP. It's not Christmas Day, although it may feel like it. It's the lowest prices in Middle Tennessee, period. Get to Stan McNabb Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram or Stan McNabb Chevrolet Buick GMC Cadillac before these prices are gone forever.
All right, the cat's out of the bag at Carroll Street Liquor in Tullahoma. Now you know where to go if you're planning a get-together and want the ideal wine or spirit. Party planning can be stressful, but at Carroll Street Liquor, you'll find everything you need. Mixers, gift sets, and all of your favorite spirit brands. So if you're feeling the pressure to pull off the ideal party, come to Carroll Street Liquor and select among the seemingly endless supply of wines, spirits, gift sets, and more. Your perfect party, it's in the bag with Carroll Street Liquors.
Welcome back. The annual Tullahoma Soapbox Derby was held on Saturday. Bob Payne brings us this video.
Are you ready? points.
This looks like a pretty close race here, too. Here they come down the straightaway. Crossing the line first is Russell Simmons. And we're on the straightaway. This looks like a pretty close race.
Today I'm here with
Alyssa Goon.
Congratulations, Alyssa. Did you have fun today?
Yes, I did.
What division did you race in?
I raced in Super Stock.
That is awesome. Are you excited about going to Akron, Ohio?
Yes.
Well, I hope you do great up there. Thank you. Okay, I'm here today with
Russell Simmons.
Russell, what division did you race in today?
Masters.
In the Masters division. Congratulations on the big win today. How does it feel being a winner?
It feels great.
That's awesome. Are you excited about going to Akron, Ohio?
I guess.
Thank you. That's a wrap for today in the Tullahoma, Tennessee Soap Derby competition. As you can see, everyone had a great time.
More News Leader is coming up in a moment.
Keith Barnett here at Russell Barnett Chevrolet GMC in Winchester. Select GMC Sierras up to $10,000 off original MSRP. That's Russell Barnett Chevrolet GMC on the bypass in Winchester, home of the lifetime powertrain warranty. And remember, my question is, why buy anywhere else?
Since the moment you were born, I've made 1,000 wishes. Wishes for your future in a world that's changing fast. Do play and laugh. Do win and lose. Do it all with confidence, kindness, and strength. And always do your best to remember that no matter what you do in this life, what matters to me is that you keep doing.
Here at Manchester Funeral Home, we know the importance of living and working in our local community because it's those families who we serve during their time of need honorably. We believe in supporting local business and offer only 100% Batesville caskets, the best in the industry and a driver of our local economy. If you want straightforward and fair pricing while working with the people you know, choose Manchester Funeral Home, serving your community since 1932. And pre-planning and pre-funding can be the best gift you ever leave your loved ones. Call us to pre-arrange. Manchester Funeral Home. Our family, caring for your family since 1932.
Welcome back. Tonight we continue with part three of Tom Corrington's interview with Dot Watson from the Coffee County Literacy Council.
As I mentioned, we're a not-for-profit organization, and so
in the past, in the early years of the Literacy Council, we would have the major fundraisers with a dinner, dance, speaker, live and silent auctions. But in 2008, when we were having a downturn in the economy, we decided not to do that because we didn't want to have to ask businesses to sponsor it and give us things to auction and that kind of thing. So since we are literacy, quote, we thought maybe working with books somehow. So for several years, what we did was go to the county fair and we drug books up there and had a booth in the main building and sold books. But the main reason was to be able to give out information to individuals who might need to sign up for the services. And that went very well, but we're getting older and it's harder to lug books. So we decided after several years, the mall here in Tullahoma, Northgate Mall, was very generous and they gave us space in the mall. And we're in the third space that we've been in because they keep giving us a little larger space, and which is needed for what we call the bookshelf. It's a used bookstore. And the community has been wonderful to bring us fantastic books of all kinds, all genres. And we operate that with mostly volunteers. We only have two paid employees, a part-time bookstore manager and another helper for 10 hours a week. And they do a really good job. And we are so pleased because we're able to serve all the surrounding communities. We have customers that come from all over, and so many people who are visiting family here from everywhere come in, and they're really happy to find the bookshelf and the selections that we have. And in the bookshelf, we sell our hardbacks for $3. We sell large paperbacks for $2 and regular size paperbacks for $1. There are some exceptions to that when we get in a very special book that has unusual value. And so we will put a different price on that. Coffee table books are in the $5 range. And we have a free box that we put ones that we don't think we can sell in. And
Outside the book. Mention where the bookshelf is, brother.
The bookshelf is in Northgate Mall.
Right.
And it's...
You go in the main entrance.
Mm-hmm.
Main,
and it's on the right.
Way.
And so we're very thankful to be there.
Yeah.
And it's an easy place to get to, and we enjoy
it. You mentioned your free books. You've got a bin you put out in front of the store.
Yes.
At which you put the books you can't sell, and they're free.
Yeah.
Just walk in, and if you see something you want, take it.
And that we put magazines in that as well.
Yeah.
And people can take those. Our Bibles are free. We want people to have access to those. And when we have them, we don't always have them.
Yeah. But, you say you take books on any subject?
We do. We do not take encyclopedias. There is no market for encyclopedias, and they take up so much space.
Wow.
We don't take old textbooks. The newer textbooks we will take, but not old ones. And it's fun. We find so many. We have one section that's just devoted to Tennessee authors, and several of those are local authors, like Inman Majors and Nancy Northcutt. We have her books in there. There are others as well.
Yeah.
Don't forget to tune into this week's Living Show tonight at 6:30 p.m., Thursday morning at 9 a.m., and Thursday, Friday, and Saturday evening at 6:30 p.m. This week's guests include Tullahoma Parks and Recreation Director Lyle Russell, who will tell us about the next Lunch and Learn coming to town. The annual post office food donation is this weekend, and we'll hear how we can all participate, and a local family needs some help. So we'll learn how to chip in on that. All that and more on this week's Living.
And stay with us. We'll have your weather forecast right after these messages.
Keith Barnett here at Russell Barnett Chevrolet GMC in Winchester. Select Silverados will receive supplier pricing and $6,500 in rebates only at Russell Barnett Chevrolet GMC on the bypass in Winchester, home of the lifetime powertrain warranty. And remember, why buy
anywhere else.
We're losing it, Doctor.
Not on my shift. Quickly, brush. Roller.
What a transformation.
It's gonna be okay.
Okay, nothing.
At Paintworks of Tullahoma, we specialize in domestic emergencies with Martin Senior paints. You can be the paint doctor, too, when you treat your home with Martin Senior interior and exterior finishes.
Doctor, we've got another one.
Got you covered.
Paintworks of Tullahoma. Come see the paint doctor, stat.
My wife, Jackie, has always been the life of the party. But things changed when she couldn't be as active anymore.
They told me I needed a double knee replacement.
It's not as big a deal as it used to be, but she still needed to go to rehab.
I was amazed at how good the therapists were at LifeCare. They took really good care of me.
They took excellent care of her. And now she's back doing the things she loves, and that makes everyone happy.
LifeCare Center of Tullahoma wants you to get active and live well.
He's a little bit of you, he's a little bit of me. He's the trash along the roads out of Tennessee. He's the garbage that we pack. He's the dream we left behind. Lord, there ain't no lower class than Tennessee trash. A throwaway bottle or a pop top can may not seem much to a traveling man, but a little bit of litter goes a long, long way.
We have met the enemy, and he is us.
Welcome back. We'll take a look at your weather forecast at this time, starting with your weather history on this day. Our record high was in 1952 at 88 degrees. The record low was in 1944 at 34 degrees. The average high on this day is 76, and the average low is 53. Clear weather expected tonight with a low of 59. Partly cloudy weather in the forecast for Wednesday with a high of 84 and a low of 66. And some storms expected in the afternoon on Thursday with a high of 78 and a low of 61. And that's our newsletter report for this evening. We invite you to join us each Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday at 6, 8, and 10 for Newsletter on 6. You have a good evening.
Have a great evening.